Today, we have a new high of 47 persons who have tested positive to the disease. Thus, Kenya now has 581 people who have tested positive from the beginning. In today's number, 32 persons are from Mombasa, while 11 are from Nairobi. We now have 2 cases in Busia, 1 in Kiambu, and 1 in Kwale. Again, the cases in Mombasa are mainly in Old Town, with 18 cases, 18 additional cases being from the Old Town, and 5 additional cases here in Nairobi, again going to Eastleigh. In terms of number, in terms of gender, once again, we have 31 who are male and 16 who are female. We are also lucky today that we have released 8 persons. 8 persons have been discharged, which brings the number of discharged persons to 190. On a sad note, though, I want to inform you that we have lost an additional 2 persons from coronavirus disease in Mombasa, bringing this number to the number of deceased persons to 26. But of more serious concern regarding those deceased persons is that both of them, aged 68 and 72 respectively, actually passed away at home. We have identified some epicenters where the numbers have continued to grow. These are especially Eastleigh in Nairobi and Old Town, Mombasa. The situation in those areas has now become of serious concern. In order to contain the spread of infection in these 2 particular areas, the government has recommended that further containment measures will be followed. Subsequently, and pursuant to Rule 3 of the Public Health COVID-19 Restriction of Movement of Persons and Related Measures, Rules 2020, Legal Notice 50, the Ministries of Health and that of Interior Coordination of National Government have directed as follows. There shall be cessation of movement in and out of Eastleigh area of Nairobi with effect from today, the 6th of May 2020, at 7 p.m. for the next 15 days. There shall be cessation of movement in the area known as Old Town in Mombasa with effect from today, the 6th of May at 7 p.m. for the next 15 days. There will be closure of any markets, any restaurants, and eateries within those 2 areas. That is, the area of Eastleigh in Nairobi and Old Town in Mombasa with effect from 6 May 2020 at 7 p.m. for the next 15 days. Further, the government has also said that the cost of targeting testing and quarantine and government quarantine facilities shall be met by the government. Kenyans should therefore forthwith not be afraid. Let me repeat that. Effective today, government quarantine facilities will be occupied by those told to do so by the Ministry of Health, will be given that facility free of charge. This is to facilitate those who may feel that they do not want to go for testing because of the cost of quarantine. That is no longer the case.